Hello, and welcome to this technical mini webinar in support of the Climate Footprint Project. The Climate Footprint Project supports state and regional governments to improve their greenhouse gas emissions tracking and reduction efforts. My name is Laura Turtle, and I am a consultant at Ricardo Energy and Environment, and this webinar will provide an introduction to emission factors. So, what is an emission factor? Emission factors will form part of the basis of your inventory, as they are required to convert activity data into greenhouse gas emissions. The emission factors you use may be default factors or based on region-specific data. Locally specific emission factors are preferable to international defaults, but make sure you are aware of their accuracy. Emission factors are generally derived from measurements made from a number of sources representative of a particular emission sector. Electricity emission factors are location and time specific. Try to use the most up-to-date electricity emissions factor available, as this will reflect changes in grid carbon intensity, such as fuel prices, meteorological impacts, and generation facility changes. Solid waste and wastewater require additional process or location-specific parameters to calculate greenhouse gases. Road transport emission factors are more accurate when using technology-specific factors. Here is a list of possible sources for you to obtain sector-specific emission factors. The IPCC 2006 guidelines and emission factor database. Tools from the Greenhouse Gas Protocol. The UK Department for Environment, Food and Rural Affairs conversion factors for company reporting. The United States Environmental Protection Agency. The Climate Registry. UNFCCC software. And the IPCC waste model. At some point during compilation, you will want to convert your greenhouse gas emissions into carbon dioxide equivalents so they can be compared. First, you will calculate tons of emissions by multiplying your activity data by an emission factor. This is the simplest form of calculation and falls under the Tier 1 IPCC methodology. If you aren't familiar with Tier 1, 2, and 3 methodologies, please see our mini webinar on this subject. In order to convert emissions to carbon dioxide equivalents, multiply your emissions, in this case tons of emissions, by the 100-year global warming potential coefficients. You will find these in the IPCC guidelines. So, in summary, emission factors play a crucial part of compiling a greenhouse gas emissions inventory. There are international default emission factors for most activities under each IPCC sector, but local are preferable if they are considered accurate. Beware of units. Ensure consistency between data and emission factors, and if needed, undertake conversions. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.